In this video, we are going to see the next numerical problem on design of DC machine. Let's consider this following numerical. In this numerical, the given data are we have to find the main dimension B, L and number of poles we have to find, as well as length of the air gap. These are the parameters we have to find. Let's proceed. We have to find the exact power produced in the armature. That is nothing but V suffix A. So this is power divided by efficiency. The power is 600 kilowatts and efficiency is 91%. The next thing is substituting into the main equation. And again, the C naught can be written as y square BAV AC into 10 to the power of minus 3. Okay. Again here, BAV is not given, it is given VG. So we can find from this equation. Also the KF value is not available in the numerical. Let us assume the value is 1. So the same BG can be considered as BAV. Let's proceed the values, and the small n is nothing but capital N divided by 60, and here the speed is 900 rpm. Let's substitute all the values. T square L equal to 0.212 meter cube. So let's separate these two values. As per given data, pole arc divided by pole pitch equal to 0.75. Let us assume square pole. So, L will be equal to pole arc. So, we can write L divided by YD divided by P equal to 0.75. L equal to 0.75 into YD divided by P. Also, in the given numerical, number of poles are not mentioned, that we have to find out. So how to find number of poles? Let's see. The speed N is equal to 120F divided by P. Or else we can rearrange this equation. Frequency equal to P into N divided by 2. Okay. And usually the frequency varies from 25 to 50 Hz. Let's check this. If frequency equal to 25 and we know that given N equal to P 15 RPS. If we substitute this parameter and this parameter, then number of poles equal to 4. Now exactly we have to find which is best, 4 poles or 6 poles. Let's proceed. We can have either pole equal to 4 or 6. These two options we are having. But we have to decide which one is having better. Let's see. To find which pole is having best option here, we have to find the current per brush arm. We know that the maximum allowed limit is 400 ampere per brush arm. Current per brush arm IB equal to 2 times of IA divided by volts. Why? Because the current which is going will be equal to how many poles we are having and what is the current drawing by the simple brush divided by 2, that we know. So we can write IA is nothing but IB into the poles divided by 2. This is just rearranged here in this equation. And this total amount that should be 400. This is limited value 400. Let's find which pole is having best option here. If poles equal to 4, then what happens? IB equal to 2 into IA divided by 4. Also, we have to find the value of IA. Again, simple formulation we will go. P equal to V into I. So power is 600 kilowatts and the voltage is 500 into I. So I will be 1200 ampere. Let's substitute this value here. So compared to these two, this is wrong and this is accepted value. 400 ampere is accepted value. So we can say number of poles are 6. Let's proceed this value to the previous. So we can write L equal to 0.75 into by D divided by poles. That is, we found 6. Let's substitute this value into the D square L equation. Let's check for peripheral speed. We know that V equal to by D N. Substitute the value of D and N is 15. So we will be having 50 meters per second. So this is permissible limit. So D is fine to operate that particular machine. And last parameter we have to find length of the air gap. Let's see. Length of air gap. The relation which is correlating both the air gap and the ampere turns, that we know that MMF required for the air gap. So MMF required for the air gap, ATG equal to LG. Also we know that ATG is nothing but 0.5 to 0.7 times of ampere turns required in the armature. In our given numerical, they have clearly mentioned that the armature MMF, out of armature MMF, 50% is used in the air gap. So we can say this amount is 0.5 times of ampere turns at the armature. Let's substitute all the given datas. And the BG is given in the numerical 0.6. Gap contraction factor, that is 1.15, and LG we have to find it. It is equal to 0.5. Again, this ampere turn per armature can be rewritten as ampere conductor into pole pitch divided by 2. Again, we can rewrite the pole pitch equal to by D divided by number of poles. So by D value is 0.8 and number of poles is 6. So this value is 0.42. Let's substitute all the values. Say LG equal to 6 mm.